Mr. Ellis want to see you in his office.
I'm in trouble, Emma.
Well, he wasn't laughing.
Well, Mr. Turner?
Overslept, Mr. Ellis.
Until 1:30? Again? If you don't want the job, there's plenty you do.
Great.
What's wrong with the job, Lee?
Boring, Mr. Ellis.
You're only just learning the trade.
It took me 2 minutes to suss out you put the cornflakes on the cornflake shelf, and 2 seconds more to guess you moved the old stock up. 2 minutes, 2 seconds, Mr. Ellis. I've been doing this job 2 months.
You've done more than stocking up, I know that.
Right. I make tea. I sweep floors. You're supposed to be teaching me a trade here. I knew tea and brooms already.
Call in tomorrow, Mr. Turner. I'll have your money and papers.
Right.
You know what I used to call the YOP scheme? Yobs occasionally punctual.
As good as that. I like it. You've got a great little team here, Mr. Ellis. I bet the sub-area manager's assistant's really pleased.
Hello, 2468021. Morgan? That Morgan, is it? No, it's just a surprise. Well, what's wrong, Morgan? Well, I can't just get away like that. Are you all right? Are you lonely on your own without Mum? I know, yes, I know. But what can I do? Well, I could perhaps come down at the weekend. Oh, no, not to stay. How can I? Sunday, maybe. Look, Morgan, the boy's just come in for his tea. I'll ring you back tomorrow, all right? Well, look after yourself. We'll think of something. Goodbye. Okay.
Packed it in. You were boring.
So you jacked it in. Let's have a cup of tea, eh?
Don't drink tea.
Oh, well, I do. I drink tea. Think of somebody else for a change. Or did you get the push? Not stealing, nothing like that.
It was just boring. I was late. Just a few times, a bit late, okay.
I've never been late for work in my life.
Fantastic. It was boring, you just don't know.
What do you mean I don't know?
You just
don't...
Now,
come on!
Back off, yeah?
You know nothing.
What's the matter? Lee? Where is he?
Don't start anything, Alan, please.
Don't let it get you, love, eh?
What time's tea, then?
When it's ready.
Lee, have you been upset?
Oh, don't take notice of you. It really matters to you, the job. What time's tea then, on your meeting?
I don't want you to go out tonight.
Why?
Because you just go out drinking to get drunk out of your mind, and you're only 17, and you just got the elbow from work, and you should... Oh, I don't know. You should feel it, you know.
Is this him?
Don't start.
Look, I was a bloody skivvy there.
It was a job.
Don't start, please, either of you.
What did you do?
Look, the money was terrible.
All right.
I wasn't much worse off before I got the bloody job.
Look, it's not just the job.
Well, what is it then?
Well, if you can't see that...
I can't.
Look, let's just keep this easy, shall we, Lee? Okay, all right?
Yeah, great. I'm easy.
Got a push then, did you?
Bloody wildfire, yeah.
So, what are you gonna do now?
I don't know, do I? Not this minute, now.
Money.
Money? Right, yeah, I've got money.
Where from?
You know where from. I work 2 months.
Enough to go drinking every night?
I don't
go. Sit your weekends, tapes, magazines, you must think we're stupid.
What's this where from?
No, I want to
just keep out of this, would you, Val, please? You steal money from your mother.
Balls, I do.
Yeah, don't risk it with me, though, do you?
I don't risk it with anyone. Just because you pay for the room and screw me mother.
Alan!
Don't ever insult your mother like that again. Ever.
Piss off.
Don't tell me to piss off! Come here, I'm bloody talking to you!
All right. That's enough. All right.
Lies in that stinking bed of his all day.
While you ride about in your big macho lorry. Up yours with a Yorkie bar.
Alan! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! It's my house. My son. Go on up to your room.
It started...
Go on, love.
begs for it, he really does.
All right, Alan.
Listen, Val, when I moved in, we agreed that if it didn't work out, then...
Oh, come on, love. You were his age once. Look, Alan. I've not had it easy, you know. What are you saying?
It's happening too often. I mean, sooner or later, one of us is going to get hurt.
You saying you want to go? Get a brush.
Nah, it's all right. I'll do it.
We've been over this before. I can't ask the boy to leave his own home.
Well, he's getting between us, isn't he? That's exactly what he wants. I mean, I don't like heavy scenes like this.
My brother phoned. He says he's lonely. I could ask Lee to go and stay with him for a while, if he wanted.
Would he?
Well, how the hell do I know? I brought you a coffee. You okay?
Why'd you let him do that? It's your house.
It hurts Alan to see me upset. He won't do it again.
Oh, sure.
He won't do it again.
I heard him coming to your room. How do you think I feel about that?
Well, old enough to know it's nothing to do with you, I hope.
Your father never hit me.
Well, he never cared that much about us. And since you brought it up, the sex part's not important.
And what do you want?
Your uncle phoned earlier. He's very lonely. He's the only family we've got. He's very lonely. He's having a bad time.
I'm not a bloody farmer.
Fine. What are you then? Tell me and I might understand a bit better. How do you see yourself?
I don't want to go to Wales. Why should I?
To help me.
Thought it was my uncle wanted the help.
Yes.
Boring.
Not like school was boring. Like this house is boring. Like the supermarket was boring. I've got a job, Lee.
I know.
You know, yes. And I checked the 20 girls pack components.
I said I know.
Into the right sections of the right compartments.
I know,
and I
know.
And I do that 5 days a week from 8:45 until 5:30.
All right.
And you talk about boredom. Yes, work's boring. That's why they pay you to do it. Morgan's been on his own on that farm since your gran died, 2 months ago. He needs somebody there. Just for a while. Just to see him through a bad time. How can I go? And I need time to see if Alan and I... talk about it tomorrow. Good night. Better if you don't come in tonight, Alan.
I like the eaters best. Wasn't that an eater?
You sod! What time is it?
11:45. What happened to you last night?
Oh, they wouldn't let me out. Bastards.
Job thing.
Stupid.
They're at the awkward age or two. Too old to have a good laugh, too young to let it all slide by. Going to pick up your money from Alice today?
Yeah, when you want. You want to get shut of me? I've got this uncle somewhere in Wales where my mother were born.
Well, you're a big boy, so I know.
Could stay around at your place for a bit, couldn't I?
Yeah, well, you know what it's like. Well, space and that.
It's not her.
Roger the lodger.
Have you got a mark?
Where?
He went for me last night. He thumped me twice. Here, look.
There's no there!
You sod!
You're cracking up your
hat! You're eating my poor bloody fish!
Oh, no! Don't hit me!
You like the idea of signing on again, do you? You don't find the prospect depressing?
Keeps me off the streets, Mr. Ellis.
Employers today want people with work experience. We were giving you that.
You weren't giving me anything. I was earning it.
Your money, your cards. What now?
Likely go straight down to the betting shop or the pub. I might mug a few grannies on the way. That's what you want to hear, isn't it?
Sit down, Lee.
Fine standing up.
I've got a boy your age.
Brain surgeon, is he?
Wears earrings. Goes about in chains and leather. You can hear him a mile off, squeaking and clinking. Now, I'm not saying I like the way he looks, but it's his life.
Disappointed, Mr. Ellis?
No. He does a night shift at the motorway service station. It's not much, but he's not on the dole. He's got status. You've not got status the minute you pick up that envelope. We've done our best for you. You won't easily get another YTS.
Every cloud has a silver lining.
What do you want out of life, Lee?
Few laughs, few mates.
You're easily satisfied, then?
I reckon that's the secret, Mr. Ellis.
Would you believe I trained as a teacher?
Oh, yeah. No bother.
Hello.
Hello.
What's this then?
£10 for, you know.
Housekeeping.
Right.
What have you been doing with yourself all day then?
Went to the job centre.
And?
And nothing. I'll go again after the weekend. Oh, and Colin says I can stay round at his place for a bit.
Thank you. Colin lives two streets away.
Well, we're getting all right, you and me. We're okay before Alan came.
Not for me. Alan tries. You don't notice. You don't take in anything you don't want to, do you? You can't give. Your father couldn't give.
Give what?
Oh, but you can take, all right. Oh, not that. That's the least. You take all my energy and all my patience. That's why I wanted you to go to Morgan. I mean, he's got more than I'll ever have. You'd have fitted together. All right. If not Morgan, where do we go from here?
Great! Right, I'll go to Wales if that's what you want.
Look, it's not what I want.
When? Mate. Sunday? I mean, I could go today, except it's a bit late. I mean, that's okay with you and him, is it? You can keep your heads out of the gas oven for one more night, can you?
Don't be ridiculous.
No, it'll make a nice change. If somebody wants me, actually and definitely wants me...
Lee, please.
No! Great! I'm great. It's a great goodbye, this. Really?
You won't be gone forever. They can't force you to stay if you don't like it.
I've only ever seen him once.
Oh!
It's Uncle.
Big farm, is it? Horses and ploughs and haystacks and things.
Yeah, as far as I remember. Saying, I've only ever been there once. I went there with the old woman when I was about 12. Yeah, it's pretty big.
We'll go down one weekend, yeah?
Where?
Bloody hell, it's like talking to a three-year-old.
He's pissed.
We're all pissed.
Why are you going so soon anyway?
Shake him up a bit.
It's really good. You should have seen the old woman's face. Mosh out. Pine.
Blue moon.
How can you drink anything that colour?
No problem.
I'll miss you, Carol.
Yeah, I'll miss you.
Yes, Skip.
Pint of best, pint of lager and a blue moon.
Okay.
Who are you?
Dracula.
My husband's only over there. If I scream, it come running. He's a professional wrestler, is my husband.
I'll be back. No one tells me what to do.
How are you, Morgan?
All right.
And here's the boy.
Grown since?
Well, he's 17 now. Still got the same old banger, then. Go and put your rucksack in the back, Lee.
from Telgarth, well. Cup of tea.
Sunday opening in Telgarth. Times have changed. This room in the front. No, we'd best get off home.
See the old boy and old girl there?
Yes, yes, I'd like that.
Lady.
It's a different generation, Morgan. Don't worry about Lee. That's one of the oldest churches in Wales, Lee.
Fantastic.
Why don't you put your anorak on?
I don't even know where we are.
We're here. Get out and close it for him anyway. Wipe your feet. Come on then, let's get you settled first. Oh, bring your rucksack. Mm. All right, Lee. What do you want?
I don't know.
Not that. Not that now. Do you want to come back home?
Don't know. I mean it. It's not...
It's not how you remembered it. I know. It's not Morgan.
Not Morgan what?
Well, he doesn't, you know, frighten you.
How do you know it's this room?
I know, because it used to be mine. You've got a wonderful view. And Alan will be here at 7.
What will he say? He'll come back home.
I thought what Alan said never bothered you. He won't say anything.
Not tonight, maybe. The next time there's any hassle, he'll start right in on it. You know he will. He'll say I couldn't handle it.
Well, you just have to decide who you're more scared of then, Alan or Morgan.
You bloody keep on about me being scared.
Look, 17's not a child. Other circumstances, you could be in the army, or working overseas, or at college. You're forever telling me you can look after yourself. 17 was my big decision time.
You ran away from here.
You are not being punished.
Is that right?
Lee, try to like it.
You can't try to like anything. You either do or you don't.
I brought us a meal. I came round for you a bit at this time.
Looks like his father, no?
Everybody says that.
Happy enough, is he?
Don't ask me, I'm only his mother. What about money now?
I'll pay him if he works. Fair play.
Well, you sort that out between you, yeah.
Don't know what for.
No, come on, Moore, take it. Well, kids can be expensive. Then I can tell him you've got it if he needs it. Is it, big brother? I knew it was for you to phone.
I didn't expect it, Val. When Dad died, there was still the old lady. I was younger then. Knocked the stuffing right out when she passed on. I didn't expect it, Val.
You're like my boy up there. You don't like to admit you're human. It's a pity you never married more.
Damn, what woman want to come here? No good for you.
Well, I'm glad you phoned.
Well, family?
Yes. Come on, ginger up. That's what Mam would have said.
Yes, she would.
What about the paperwork? You up to it?
Close books to me. She could do it. Damn if I can. I got an accountant chappy in Abba now.
How's Pew? He must be getting on.
He's fit as a flea. I couldn't do without him, that's a fact.
Cook tea in half an hour.
What, you gonna wait for your man?
No, he'll get something on the way.
Got him trained, say?
Not that one. Lee? Tea in half an hour!
Always a fair cook, your mother. Always make a good meal.
Quiet time on the farm?
Bit of edging, bit of ditching, early lambs.
Not much more you can do this time of year. Mm. Where are you going?
I'll wait for Alan outside.
Finish your food.
There's a torch by the door.
It's hard for him, Morgan.
You found it then?
Just about. I didn't know whether this was it or not.
Till I saw you.
That's why I came out.
Oh, it's bloody cold.
Come in. Watch the yard, it's full of cow shit.
Evening.
Come in, please.
Down there. What time did you leave?
About four.
What's that?
Show you inside.
Thank you. Hello. Early?
Well, I finished early, didn't I?
Have you met Morgan?
We said hello, yeah.
This is Alan.
How are you?
Very well, yes.
Good.
There's a cup of tea in the pot, Alan, if you...
No. Not for me, thanks, no.
Well, I...
Sit down. Why not?
Right.
And I'll just wash these few things up. Lee, come and give me a hand, please.
Well, you're out in the wilds here.
Which way you come? Hereford?
Yeah, M6. Worcester, Hereford, Hay, Brecon Road.
Three cocks?
Yeah.
Four when you come through.
Sorry?
It's a joke round here.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's nice to see an open fire.
We sucks the dust from the room.
We've got to be off soon. I don't want to leave you here if you hate it. I've given Morgan money if you need anything. Look, phone me tomorrow, all right? See how you make out, and then if it's hopeless, we'll come and fetch you on Thursday after work, all right?
All right. Everyone keeps asking, all right. Yeah, great, fantastic. I'm not a kid.
Got a present for you. Yeah, I knew you'd miss your music.
Didn't bring any tapes.
Tapes.
Okay, thanks. Thanks, Alan.
I've told him we'll come and pick him up on Thursday after work if he doesn't like it.
Why shouldn't he like it?
Well, I'll just go and get my things together.
Well?
Well, what?
Give it a go, Lee. A real go. Try.
I'm sorry about the other night.
Give us a chance, Lee, pal and me. We need time out. Do you know what I mean?
She's my mother.
Don't even think about it. Let her be her own woman for a change.
Thanks for that.
You'll be okay. It's a great place. I'd have loved it at your age. Ta.
I'll go and get the gate open.
Ta.
See you then.
You're not coming to see us off?
See you.
See you then, Lee.
Phone me tomorrow then, all right?
Come on, love.
Bye.
Bye.
Sure then, Lee.
Cheers.
Leaving him in that mood.
Val, get into the car. I'll reverse into your yard.
Don't turn round. Keep on down here, 100 yards. Turn right. Take you down the main road.
All right, cheers.
I'll take care of him.
Good luck.
Look after yourselves. We'll see you again soon.
Get him working. Bye. Are you Welsh always like this when you trip over your roots? That accent of yours. It's a riot.
You're away then. Ice on the roads. Long drive.
Did you ask for me to come here? Or was it their idea?
What difference, sir?
Why did you phone?
Well, your mother's family.
She left here when she was 17. She's only ever been back twice.
She's all the family I've got left. Bar you.
What did they tell you about me?
You can't settle.
Fight with Alan.
You were lucky to have someone to fight with, boy.
You don't have to live here.
Oh, damn, no, you're right there.
Well, then.
I'm 47, boy. I was born in the old lady's room upstairs. School, it was down to the village. And leave at 14. I don't know much. I know this farm. That's all I know. I don't have to live here, you said. Where else should I live, say? Will you work?
I'm not here to work. I'm here to get me out of the way.
I'm lonely, boy. My name's Morgan. Have you ever been lonely?
Yeah. Where did my grandmother and grandfather die? In this house?
Not in your room.
Night, then.
Night.